So hi Nishank, thank you so much for joining us today. Congratulations on scoring 99.16 percentile in CAT 2020.
Thank you so much.
Firstly, can you tell us a little bit about your profile and when you started preparing for CAT and all that?
Sure, so I'm a student, I'm a graduate of IIT Madras. I graduated in 2017.
Okay.
And since then I've been working in MBB labs as a product engineer. Basically, I develop applications. And this year, 2020, was my third attempt actually. So I started preparing from July, around mid of July or so. And I didn't used to get much time because of, you know, work and all. And because of this work from home scenario, there was even more work because then you are expected to be present all the time. So I didn't used to get much time because of all those things. But yeah, I somehow, you know, dedicated 2 or 3 hours per day, and weekends I used to like prepare for even more time, and I did my preparation in that way. So 2019 I got 96.3 percentile.
Okay.
And 2020 I got 99.16 percentile. So the main reason I think in 19 I got 96.3 percentile was because, you know, because of the lack of mocks basically. I was revising concepts. I was seeing what formulas were there and how to solve VARC questions and all those things I was revising in 2019 as well, but I didn't take and analyze much many mocks at that time. So in 2020 I changed that, and I tried to do more mocks, and you know, so I improved a lot in my percentile.
Great. So can you tell us what CRACO resources aided you in your preparation?
So yeah, actually for the working professionals, I think the daily tasks that CRACU has, so you what CRACU does is it releases 3 tests per day, one for English, one for DILR, and one for quantitative ability. So those 3 tests per day, if you solve, it doesn't take more than 1 hour. It takes 45 minutes to 1 hour. And if you solve all those 3 tests, you are constantly in touch with your preparations. If you're not getting time to, you know, revise a lot of questions, you're not getting time to write mocks every day, you're not getting time to practice a lot of questions, you can just take those tests, give 1 hour to your CAT preparation, and it makes a difference. It makes a lot of difference. So what I used to do was I used to solve those questions almost daily. And apart from that, I used to take mocks during weekends or at any other time I got. Obviously, the reduction of time from 3 hour to 2 hour definitely helped me take more mocks. So that was there. But so I would also say that the mock tests of CRACU had pretty good questions. So that also helped me a lot, because the analysis part was very good. And what I liked the most was the video solutions and all from Maruti sir and Sayali ma'am. Both were great.
Great. So can you tell us about your strategy that you followed in each section?
Okay. So first of all, the thing is, you have to know that any CAT aspirant has to know that if there are 100 questions, you have to solve in 180 minutes. You cannot solve all the 100 questions. So you have to know how to leave the questions. So for VARC, what I used to do was, first I start with RC. This time there were 4 RC passages, and there was 40 minutes. So I knew that I can only do 3 RC passages. So the first, I was in slot 2, and the first RC passage itself was on visual arts. And as soon as I read 2 lines, I knew that, okay, this RC passage I cannot do. So I was like, okay, if I get time in the end, I'll come back to it. So I left that RC passage completely. I completed the other 3 RC passages, which incidentally were much more easier than the first one, visual arts one. And then I went on to VA section and completed the VA section as well. So what I mean is that, okay, you have to read the passages. You cannot just, you know, blindly read all the passages and do all the questions. If you do that, you will end up getting a lot of negative marks. So you have to rate the passages. You have to make your system of rating. You have to rate the passages. And then you have to decide that, okay, this is the passage I will leave it to the end. This is an easy passage, let me do it right now. And something like that. You have to go in that way for the VA. So for the DILR section, what one has to do is, according to me, you cannot solve all the 8 or how many ever DILR passages are there, how many DILR sets are there. You cannot solve all of them. So you definitely have to choose the sets that you want to solve. Since CAT doesn't, you know, CAT is not like GMAT. GMAT gives more marks to the harder questions and less to the easier ones. But CAT is not like that. It gives same marks for each and every question. You have to take the easiest sets and solve them. So you have to, you know, first see the sets and say that, okay, this is a set from a standard, you know, this is a standard set like games and tournaments or arrangement or something like that. A simple standard set, and I can solve it right. If you see that the hints given are pretty straightforward and they're not deductive. They're like plugins, pretty straightforward plugins hints. You can just use them and solve them. So if you find a set like that, go for it at the starting. You don't have to start from the first set. You can start from the fifth set as well. So in that way, you have to finish two or three sets, which will make you clear your cutoff. And then you can look for scoring more, maximizing your score. Again, in the math section, what I used to do was I used to skim for the questions which were the easiest. I say that, okay, question is A and the answer is B. So if I know the path from A to B, then I can just go for it. Then I can just solve the question then and there, whether it takes me 2 minutes or 5 minutes. I can solve the question then and there. But if I don't know exactly how to go from A to B, then I cannot. Then I would just mark the question and come back to it later. If I don't know the concept, I will obviously I don't even need to mark the question because then it is of no use.
Right.
That is the individual strategy that I followed. Okay, so just one more thing I would like to add in the preparation strategy. So the thing is, CAT is, I feel that CAT is more of a strategy test rather than knowledge test, you know, because okay. The questions are pretty basic. The questions are not as such, you know, very tough questions, pretty basic 10th, 12th level questions. But where people fail is the strategy. They don't know how to, they don't strategize it properly. So like I told you that, okay, first you have to solve all the easiest questions and then you can go for the tougher ones. But in general, what happens is we tend to get stuck on a hard question and then we lose time for the easy ones.
Right.
So it's very important to strategize properly. And in that way, you can, you know, maximize your score.
Great. So can you tell us what was your weakest section and what was your strategy in that section?
Okay, so when I started taking the mocks, VARC and DILR, these two sections were giving me a lot of trouble because, I'm an engineer and I always used to perform well in maths, but VARC and DILR used to give me a lot of troubles, especially because of the close answers, close options in VARC and DILR. It's like sometimes it just doesn't, you know, strike in your mind, okay, this hint can be plugged in this way. So what I used to do for VARC was, there will be questions in one passage. If there are five questions, there will be at least two or three questions which will be direct questions, which will be directly from the passage, and you don't have to deduce anything in those questions. So I used to solve those questions first, and I didn't go for the other questions, say reasoning questions or the critical reasoning questions or the inference questions and all those things. I didn't used to go for them first. So the direct questions, you can again go back to the passage, read the passage again and come back and answer that question. This time actually the CAT paper required a lot of going back to the passage and reading the questions. So that's how I improved my score in English, because in the VARC section, because if there are close options and you get stuck between two options, you have to, you know, if you're reasonably sure about one option, you can take an educated guess. But if you are like 50-50, you should not, according to me, you should not take an educated guess on that. And you should just leave that question because a negative mark is not worth it.
Right.
And my strategy for the DILR set was to practice more and more sets. There is nothing else you can do for DILR, because in the end, what happens is if it doesn't strike in that moment, if it doesn't strike your mind that, okay, this can be solved in this way, you won't be able to solve it, and it will only strike if you have a lot of practice.
Right. So can you tell us how did you stay motivated during this whole journey?
Okay, so actually there were a lot of things. First of all, stay clear of the social media posts. They'll demotivate you like anything. You'll read things like, okay, gems won't get calls and all those things. So just stay clear of the social media posts. And the second thing is you can read books, you can listen to music, you can see, you can watch movies, all those things you can do. You don't have to get, I have to study for 24 hours or something like that. So what I used to do was I used to read a lot of self-help books. One particular book that I read was How Will You Measure Your Life? And it says that if done well, management is the most noble profession of all. So I was like, okay, if I can get through this, I will get to that, and I will be able to help so many people. I will be able to get achieve my goals of leadership. I will be able to inspire a lot of people to achieve their goals. And in that way, you know, so my I was more focused on the end goal rather than getting into an IIM. Getting into an IIM is the path, but your end goal is something else. So I was more focused on that, and that is how I stayed motivated.
Brilliant. So can you tell us what was that one most important thing according to you that actually helped you improve your scores?
According to me, the most important thing was to drop my ego.
Okay.
Being an engineer, what I used to do in quantitative ability was I used to get stuck with a question, and I was like, okay, how is that possible that I cannot solve this question? A simple question, like if they're asking area of the triangle and somehow something happened and I am not able to solve it, just leave the question, go ahead, solve another question. In that way, I was able to solve around 13, 14 questions this time. With 100% accuracy, but getting stuck on a question, what happens is you're not able to reach the end. So if there are 34 questions, you have to make sure that you see all the 34 questions. You cannot be like, okay, I have seen 25 questions and I solved 25. Even if you see 25 questions and you solve 18 of them, you haven't seen the 9 questions. Maybe those 9 were the easiest questions and you missed those 9 questions. So you have to drop your ego. If you get stuck on a question, if you cannot solve it within 2 to 3 minutes, just leave it. If you know exactly how to solve a question, then you should not take more than 2 to 3 minutes to solve that question. So then you can go for that question. So most important thing is to drop the ego. And for the working professionals and for the like final year college students, I would like to say that after getting into an IIM, what they want to learn is management, right? What they want to learn is strategy. But they have to practice it from right now. As in, if you have a priority, say CAT is your priority, and you give that half an hour per day, it's not your priority, it's just a good intention. When you make something your priority, you have to allocate your resources, and your resources are your time and energy. You have to allocate the resources to that. So if you allocate your resources in that way, then it becomes your priority. So for the college graduates and for the working professionals, for both of them, it's very important that you allocate adequate amount of resources to CAT preparation as well and to your job, because obviously you cannot leave your job. You have to allocate adequate amount of resources to your job and your CAT preparations both. So what I did was work from home scenario helped. It was both a boon and a bane for me. You know, I used to complete all the work and whatever time in between, you know, when we used to be in office, we used to go for tea and all those things. So people would take break. But over here, we could just, you know, get to the preparation and solve 10 questions or so like that. So those things are there. Yeah.
Great. So finally, are there any tips that you would like to give the future CAT aspirants?
Definitely. One most important thing which I feel everyone should know is you need to love this exam. You need to, you know, be in love with this exam like you love your girlfriend or your mom and dad. What I feel is you need to enjoy the whole process. It's not just this exam. There's a process after that as well. And you need to enjoy the whole process. You might not end up in IIM in the end, but there are other exams. There are other colleges. There are colleges which are as good as IIMs and you can get into those as well. So the most important thing is to love the process and love the exam, enjoy the exam. In fact, what happened with me was after 29th November, I started missing the exam. So
okay.
That's how it was with me. After 29th November, I was like, okay, now that I'm done with CAT, what do I do now? So it's something like that. I was so engrossed in the process that, okay, I really missed the exam after that. I think CAT is a beautiful exam. You know, no other exams in India test your strategy in the way CAT does. So just enjoy the process, enjoy the questions. And when you see a question, you should be curious. Oh, wow, this something like, wow, okay, such a question could be made. Let's see how to solve this question. So something like that.
Right.
I think those things really help when you take the pressure off your mind. I always used to follow this one what Bhagavad Gita says, that karm karte jao phal ki chinta mat karo. I used to follow that, ki okay, this is what I have to do, results are not in my hand. That's what I would like to say to the CAD aspirants.
Brilliant. So thank you so much, Nishank. Thanks for your time and thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, Kushal. Thank you so much.